Guys, Mark Goldberg here from Mark Vlogs Watches with a quick word for your friend and mine, Archie Luxury, Paul Pluta, AC3, Archibald Chesterfield III. You know, he invented the quick wristwatch check, and the rest of us on YouTube, well, we just stole it. Help keep Archie full-time on YouTube by liking this video, watching this video, tell your fuckhead friends, and make sure to subscribe to his Patreon. And now, Archie Luxury.
But in there, there's all these azaleas. Yeah. Those yellow ones have grown up, but they'll die later. And then the azaleas, it's protecting the azaleas.
Merry Christmas! Azaleas. Happy New Year!
No, that corner.
Yeah, no, the whole side, there's about 20 azaleas there.
Oh, okay.
But you can't see them because those plants have taken over.
Yeah.
You know? Mm. And that's all right, because those plants will die, and the azaleas, but it's protecting them from the sun.
Hi guys, Paul Pluta on the Paul Pluta channel today. Guys, I'm doing a paid review. This is a paid review. It's for David. This is paid review 9N61. Remember guys, these paid reviews, they keep me full time on YouTube. That's exactly right there. This here is a paid review. He goes, hello Archie, I attach the actual watches too. Orient Star is now on the way now from Japan. Hopefully you talk about it in the vids. Most of the watches in the lower price range were gifts from family and my wife, so limited budgets, but I approve every watch prior purchase, so they're very dear to me. I'm mostly interested in higher end advice and what you think of my Grail. So this is an interesting email here. It's an interesting email. And he did send me a bit more information there. He doesn't have all garbage. They're not all garbage, but they're also not so cool either. And I would say, you know, sometimes in life when you're asking family for gifts, they say, oh, what can you get me? Get a gift. I gotta tell you something, man. Stop getting fucking garbage watches. There are so many gifts that are really affordable, but are cool. What I would say is there's so many gifts. For example, you know, someone wanted to give me a gift. Like, a lot of women ask for gifts in dating. Don't worry about it, it's short-lived. It doesn't last long. I said to one, don't buy me fucking clothes. I'm fat. I don't want clothes that they're going to be too big or too small. Very hard for you to get the right size. Give me cufflinks. I want accessories. Accessories are so much cooler than an actual piece of clothing. The other thing I always like when it comes to watches, you don't have to buy a Rolex or a Patek Philippe. How about someone gets you a nice watch box or a nice book on Rolex? That's right. Go to Amazon, find a couple of books and say, how about you get me one of these? That's how you can build up your library. So you don't have to get expensive. They don't have to have a huge budget to get something that actually means a lot. So I got to tell you, man, I think you might be going about it the wrong way. So let's have a look here. He then said to me, hi Art, since you're making the video, I figured some more info is warranted. The Tissot was a gift from my dad for med school graduation. It's a keeper. Fuck, I mean, you're graduating med school, they give you a fucking Tissot? You've got to be joking. Okay, the Hamilton was a gift from my wife after residency training. Residency's so fucking hard! It's a keeper. Tag Aqua Racer, gift from my mum for my birthday. Okay, that's semi-decent. Orient, my first watch brand, got me into mechanicals. Yeah, but Russian alarm, love alarms. Unfortunately, Russian ones are the only affordable options for beta alarms. I still need an affordable chronograph racing style for gym playing sports. Speedy reduced, any thoughts? The real collection, only has the Tudor Black Bay 58 and the Hoyer Monaco. Good start, I think. Let me know what you think of the rest of the choices in the future. Pick below. What do you think of my Grail? I'm a newly minted doctor paying off loans and other debts, so can't go crazy. Thank you. You helped me a lot avoid the bullshit. Okay, fair enough there. So his Grail. His Grail is the Oh, it's the Patek Pilot watch. Yes, 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 yes. Personally, it's not really my cup of tea. I would be more inclined to say go for a Calatrava. That's where I would be going because it's precious metal, great bang per buck on the second-hand market, and it's just cool as fuck. I got a quick wristwatch check. I'm wearing a 5127. I gotta be honest with you there, man. Seriously, okay, you've got the... Okay, look, I see where you're coming from, but, man, my best advice to you is, in future, if a loved one wants to buy you a present, they don't have to get you a watch. They could get you a watch book. There are many good watch books which are great to get. That's what I'd be asking for, because there aren't many good watches. I mean, fuck, man. Okay, so you're starting off. Okay, let's not give you a too hard a time there. The Black Bay 58, that's a great starter watch. The Aqua, I don't even mind the Aqua Racer. It's a cool modern watch. Young Doc can't spell. That's kind of cool, David. You've got the Hoyer. Now, I am pleased you've got the... Let me just double check that, because I'm not sure whether your graphic is right or wrong. But I tell you honestly, you have got... What have you got here? Shit, this fucking Google phone is going all over the fucking shop here. Here we go. Let me just have a look. Oh, you've got the Caliber 11. Wow, well done, well done, well done. Look, I would say to you, seriously, I would add some very well-priced chronographs. Yes, I love a chronograph. Look, I gotta say, in honesty, I get where you're coming from. Please, no more garbage, okay? Please, just promise me no more garbage. I like the Hoyer. The Monaco Caliber 11, that is a classic, iconic. The Steve McQueen, it's let down by that fucking Sellita movement. That fucking shits me off, man. That's why I just fucking... That kind of pisses me off. But I actually did... I think the Monaco was cool. Yeah, it was fucking cool. Very cool. Very cool. You've got the Black Bay 58. I reckon it's a better size. It's under 40 mil. The standard size one, it's a bit big, very tall, wears really big. So I tend to agree with you. I'll give you some couple of really cool things to add. You've got to buy these secondhand. You cannot buy these new. I'd be looking at a Omega Speedmaster Man on the fucking Moon. Okay, you might buy that from Joma Shop. That's a good buy. Another great thing I would get is a Breitling Super Ocean Heritage. I'd probably go for the Series 1, which has got the aluminum bezel and the ETA movement. They are very soft on the secondary market. You could pick one of those up for $2 to $2.5 US. Great buying. I think another excellent buy, a bit of horology at a budget price, would be a Breguet Type 20. I've owned that model a few times. I only flipped it because I upgraded to Rolex, then I upgraded to Patek. So I think it's a very special type of watch there indeed. It is special. So I'd add one of those. What else would I add? I'd probably add a PAM, except don't buy anything retail. Doc, you're going to become a bit of a cunt, okay? Become a bit of a cunt. You get a PAM 111 or a 112. or a base model. Just simple PAM, that'd be very cool. A PAM would be secondhand because they're toxic shit. Make sure with PAM you stay away from white dial. It must have box papers and preferably receipt. That's correct, receipt. That's how bad PAM faking is there. But Watchfinder won't tell you that because they won't tell you that because, you know, everything's just rigged on their channel. So I gotta tell you, seriously, Watchfinder's owned by Richmond. That's the reason, fuckers. I would be adding good pieces. You can build this collection up. I think that the Tudor and the Monaco is a big watch that wears really big. I'm surprised you went for the 58, but that's quite a cool way to go. Also the Tudor Pepsi, that's right, the GMT Tudor Black Bay Pepsi, that's amazing. I love that. I also love the Tudor Monaco. I think that as a chronograph, 2 reg chrono is fucking cool. Yeah, that's what I would doing there. What do I think of Orient? Orient's garbage. Orient Star is garbage, man. Stay away from the crap. Look, I think honestly, if someone wants to give you a gift, get a watch book. There's so many other things you can get there. You don't have to just get a fucking shitty fucking garbage watch. There's no point collecting garbage. There is absolutely no fucking point to collect garbage. It is stupid, man. It's stupid. You've got a good start. You've got a couple nice watches. Add a few more bargains. And I would always, I would tell you, young doc, get a Rolex. Add a Rolex. That's correct. Add a Rolex. I would add a Rolex. Add a Rolex. That's what I would do. I would add a Rolex because every man needs a Rolex. I'd probably go Steel Sports three-hander. Okay, so three-hander, no date. Okay, I reckon the Milgauss, pre-owned. The Air King 40 mil, beautiful. That's the new Air King. Or the Explorer 1. I reckon that'd add a bit of substance to your collection. Stay away from the garbage. If someone wants to give you a gift, tell them to give you a book on Rolex. Go to Amazon, add it to your wish list, share it with them. I don't have an affiliate link. I can't be fucked, but that's the sort of thing I'd be asking for. Stay away from garbage watches. You've got enough of them already. Yeah, that's kind of how I see it. Look, it's great you're a doc. You're going to earn big bucks. Just take it easy and work hard. I'm Paul Pluto. This has been a paid review for Dr. David. Please, guys, remember, like, subscribe, tell your fuckhead friends, and don't be afraid to put some nasty, inappropriate comments below. Don't forget, also, paid reviews keep me full-time on YouTube. Without these paid reviews, I'd sink. I would sink. So please, guys, remember, paid reviews keep me on the tubes. If you want a paid review, come to me and I'll do a review. I'll try my best for you. So guys, paid reviews. Don't forget, you can also sponsor on the fridge, the refrigerator. Until next time, ciao, fuckaroonies. David SW. David SW, David SW. Who does Archie Luxury recommend is the greatest grey market dealer in America? There's only one choice, David SW. That's right, guys. I've got to tell you the honest truth. I have, for a long time, been looking for the perfect answer. Who do I recommend people go to see? Who do I recommend that people can go and buy watches? And I've got to be honest with you, the greatest pre-owned dealer for Rolex, Patek Philippe, Audemars Piguet is David SW. David SW. David SW. DavidSW.com. That's right, guys. I have been looking for a contact who I can very nicely refer people to. I am not in the selling business. Customer service, I'm too old to sell watches. I'm too old. I like to recommend my viewers to a reliable source. In Australia, I've got some great sources. There's Sydney Watch Exchange with Cove, Ronnie at Vintage Watch Co, Shani at European Watch Gallery. And in America, who is the best source for pre-owned Rolex, for all the hot models? There's only one person I would recommend, David SW. David SW, David SW. That is the premier source for pre-owned Rolex. I gotta be completely frank and honest with you. Guys, if you are looking for a hot Rolex model, there is only one place you can go to. David SW, David SW, David SW. Let's be honest, guys, there's no point schmoozing the dealers, the ADs. They're just a waste of time. Unless you're going to buy 20 pieces, you are wasting your time. What you're better off to do is pay the market premium and go to a good pre-owned dealer. Who do I recommend? David SW. David SW. David SW. That's correct, guys. I want to tell you this now. I 100% stand behind David SW. David SW, the greatest pre-owned dealer in the entire United States of America. That's right. The greatest pre-owned dealer for Rolex, for Patek Philippe, for Audemars Piguet, David SW. He even does things like F.P. Jean. David SW. David SW. David SW. That's right. If you want to buy a pre-owned Rolex, a Patek Philippe, Audemars Piguet, there's only one good source I would recommend. David SW. David SW. David SW. I'm Paul Pluter, the method actor who plays Archibald Chesterfield III, and I'm proud to recommend David SW. See you later. Thank you for watching this channel.
friendship ceases from now on. If you can't say anything real nice, it's better not to talk at all, is my advice.